Gritty YouTubers, here is the guy with the Swiss accent. We all know the ultrasonic range sensors. And we all know the infrared sensors to detect presence of something. Today, I show you the latest technology which combines the two. A few years ago, this technology costed thousands of dollars, and today we can buy it for 10 bucks on AliExpress. But does it really work? Or is it fake? And can I build a LIDAR sensor which prevents my self-balancing robot from driving into obstacles? Sometimes ago, I purchased one of these new sensors and presented it in my mailbag. An employee of the manufacturer of the chip offered to send me an evaluation kit to get a head start. Thank you very much. Today I will use this kit to test whether the sensor works and how accurate it is. In a next episode I will use it with the Arduino. Only if it works, of course. But what is so revolutionary? We all know how the ultrasonic range sensors work. Their loudspeaker sends an ultrasonic sound towards the target we want to know the distance, and a microphone listens to the echo. Then, the controller can calculate the distance the sound traveled from the loudspeaker to the microphone. If you divide it by two, you get the distance to the object. This is possible because the speed of sound is known, and it is constant if the air pressure does not change a lot. According to Google, the speed of sound at sea level is 340 meters per second. A distance of 1 meter leads to a difference of 2 divided by 340 meters equals roughly 6 milliseconds, which can easily be detected by our Arduinos. But it means also that you have to wait 6 milliseconds for the result. Because you do not know how far the obstacle is and the range can be up to 5 meters, you even have to wait 5 times 6 milliseconds, which is 30 milliseconds, to be sure you will not get an echo. 30 milliseconds doesn't seem to be a lot, but if you have a self-balancing robot driving full speed, this can easily be a few centimeters. And if you want to measure several directions with the same sensor, you easily need a second to scan 180 degrees. And this is an absolute no-go. This is why I had to use 3 ultrasonic sensors, one for each direction. All 3 work in parallel. You find this sensor in episode number 42. What would happen if we replace sound with light? The speed of light is not measured in meters per second. It is measured in kilometers per second. And it is 300,000 kilometers per second, which is a staggering 1 million times faster than speed of sound. So we only have to wait 30 nanoseconds for a result. Great! But it is also very difficult to achieve this exact measurement from a technological point of view. But obviously, ST is able to do it, and in addition, for little money. So let's now check if it works. The chip uses invisible light at 940 nanometers. Unfortunately, light bulbs and sunlight contain also light in this spectrum, which disturbs our measurement. That is why the range of the device depends on if you use it outdoors or indoors. And also which color the target has. Maximum is 2 meters, but I would expect not more than 1 meter in normal conditions, which is okay for my robot. So let's start to play with a module. Fortunately, I got this small controller board with a microprocessor and an USB connection, a shield with one sensor and a 7-segment display, which is Arduino compatible. And 2 additional sensors. In addition, ST provides a program to try these sensors. The setup and installation was very easy and very well documented. This sensor is mainly made to detect gestures. So let's test if it is able to detect gestures. First gesture is moving towards the sensor. No problem with detection. Now flying over the sensor in either direction. Also no problem. These gestures could also be detected with ultrasonic sensors. But now I do something which is not possible with ultrasonic sensors. I cover the sensor with glass to protect it against the elements. What do you think? Will it still work? Yes, it still works. This is very important for all sorts of devices. You cannot use ultrasonic sensors in harsh conditions, and in addition, they are much, much bigger. This device also let me connect two more sensors. With these sensors, I can even distinguish the direction of horizontal movements. But, as said before, I do not plan to use more than one sensor. Now I want to test my main application, measuring distance. I will not test it on my bench, because I have quite strong LED lamps here. I test it where the robot will move later on, close to the floor. So I mounted the sensor on my third hand.
1 meter.
Now I place an A4 sheet, or also a legal sheet of white paper, at different locations and read the measurements.
90 centimeters, 80 centimeters, 60 centimeters, 40 centimeters, 20 centimeters. Quite accurate. Now I check how far it goes. So 125, 120.
As a result, we see the longer the distance, the bigger also the difference of the measurement. But at least it is reproducible, and if we need a better precision, we could calibrate the device for a few points. Or we could reduce the measuring speed and get more precision. For my purpose, this is not so important. Speed is much more important. Luckily, the module can be connected via I2C. So we could also connect more than one in parallel. Unfortunately, there is no possibility to change the I2C address of 52 hex. Also, this is not important for my LIDAR. LIDAR stands for Light Detection and Ranging. It produces a curve of the distance around the sensor, like a radar. A famous example is the LIDAR on the self-driving vehicles from Google. These devices use laser and cost a fortune. Can we build such a device with our cheap sensor? But for smaller distances, of course. My robot will not drive on a German highway. But how fast can this sensor measure? In the datasheet, I find that the fastest measurement is 20 milliseconds, which is somehow disappointing for me. Speed of light is 1 million times faster than the speed of sound. And the sensor only works 50% faster. But I sent a mail to the manufacturer. Maybe there is a trick. One decision is if we want to turn only 180 degrees or if we want to have the whole 360 degrees. Because the robot can move in both directions, 360 degrees would be cool. What do we need in addition to the sensor for our LIDAR? For sure we need a motor. We can use a small stepper, a servo, which we hack for continuous movement, or a normal small DC motor. Because the sensor has to turn fast, I do not want to stop it and reverse direction. I would prefer that it can turn only in one direction. But then we need something which connects this turning platform with the fixed main processor of the robot. Here I have such a mechanical part. We can turn one part and the other stands still. And it can connect up to 12 electrical connections in parallel. This is more than enough. And of course, we have to use our sensor with an Arduino, and therefore I need a library. Fortunately, Pololu has one. So we have everything together which is necessary to build our LIDAR. Summarized, we get with these time of flight sensors a new, very promising technology. The sensors work also through glass and are very small. Unfortunately, they do not work as fast as I thought, but still, we should be able to perform 50 measurements per second. We get them cheaply from our usual source. An Arduino library exists. There is still a lot of work to be done, and it's not sure if I will be successful. I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. If true, then like. Bye.